In the previous video, Configuring Boundaries and Repairing Surface Defects in Converge Studio, we demonstrated how to flag surface triangles to boundaries and repair surface defects in a basic representative geometry. In this video, we will apply those techniques to the port fuel injected engine geometry mentioned at the beginning of the video series. Dividing a geometry into boundaries and assigning surface triangles to those boundaries allows us to prescribe surface motion for various boundaries, assign different boundary conditions such as temperature, apply different mesh refinement strategies in different portions of the geometry, and more. Now that we are finished with the shock tube, we will load the engine geometry. For demonstration purposes, we will start with the file ICE_geometry.stl. This file is an STL file as exported from a CAD program. No boundaries have been flagged, and the surface contains some defects that we will repair. Click New Project to open a new project. As before, go to File, Import, Import STL. Navigate to the directory in which you saved the IC engine geometry, select the STL file, and click Import. As with the previous surface, there are no boundaries in the imported geometry. We will create boundary fences, boundaries such as the piston, liner, and head, and assign surface triangles to these boundaries. These boundaries make repairing surface defects easier, allow you to set boundary conditions, and group boundaries into regions such as the cylinder, intake system, and exhaust system, and set up initial conditions for the regions. Converge Studio uses boundary fences to simplify the process of flagging boundaries. Boundary fences are a tool used only by Converge Studio and do not affect your Converge simulation in any way. We will start by creating boundary fences. Go to Geometry, Boundary, Find/Clean. Click Find. Converge Studio draws boundary fences where the angle between normal vectors of adjacent triangles is between the upper and lower bounds. Since this geometry is relatively complex, the automated boundary fence tool does not create all of the boundary fences that you need, and you need to manually draw some boundary fences. For example, if you zoom in on the geometry, there is not a light pink boundary fence between the head and the liner. In the geometry dock, click on the fence tab. Verify that the biselected edges option is highlighted. In the Objects toolbar, choose the Edge Selection criterion, and from the Selection Filter drop-down menu, choose By Arc. Zoom in on the liner and head portion of the geometry and carefully click on a single edge between the liner and head. Zoom out to verify that Converge Studio has highlighted the closed loop between the head and the liner, and click the Mark Fence button. Repeat this process to mark boundary fences between the head and each of the four ports. Note that at the intake ports, the intake valves intersect the ports. We will resolve this error later, but in the meantime, change the selection criterion to triangle and the selection mode to box. Select a top view. Highlight a portion of the intake port, right-click, and choose Hide Selection. Change the selection criterion back to Edge and the selection mode back to Cursor Pick. Zoom in and carefully select an arc that is part of the intake port. mark the boundary fence. If you make an incorrect selection, use the Clear All or Clear Last buttons. Redisplay the hidden triangles by right-clicking in the graphical window and choosing Redisplay. If you need to create short but precisely placed boundary fences, go to the Fence tab and click the Between Two Vertices Radio button. Converge Studio will automatically change the selection criterion to Vertex and the selection filter to Any. Click on Two Vertices and click Mark Fence to create a boundary fence between them. Now, create fences for the remaining ports. You also need to divide the intake port, which is the longer of the two ports, into two boundaries so you can set different initial conditions. At the location where the intake port converges slightly, click on an edge. If your selection highlights a partial arc around the port, click another edge, and Converge Studio will highlight another partial arc. Repeat this process until you have selected the edges that form a closed loop around the port where it converges slightly. Click Mark Fence. Next, we will create boundaries and flag the appropriate surface triangles to them. In the Geometry dock, click on the Boundary button and then on the Flag tab. Click the plus button to open the Boundary Definition dialog box. In the Boundary Name field, type Piston and click OK. You will see this boundary in the Boundary list of the Flag tab. Although you can create multiple boundaries at once, for clarity, we will start with a single boundary. Rotate the geometry so that you can see the bottom of the cylinder. Choose the triangle selection criterion in the By Boundary Fence selection filter. Click on any surface triangle on the bottom of the cylinder. When you select this triangle, Converge Studio propagates that selection to collect all triangles for the boundary until the operation detects a boundary fence. Select the piston in the boundary list and click Apply. The surface triangles will change color to match the assigned color for this boundary. Now create liner and head boundaries. Click on any surface triangle on the liner to select the liner, click Liner in the boundary list, and click Apply. Repeat this process for the head. Create a boundary named Spark Plug. Click on the surface triangles near the center of the head to select the spark plug. Assign these surface triangles to the spark plug boundary. The intake port is the longer of the two ports and has a fuel injector on it. Recall that we created a boundary fence halfway up the intake port. Now, we will divide the intake port into two boundaries, the portion upstream of the injector and the portion downstream of the injector. This allows us to specify a refined mesh downstream of the injector to resolve the spray correctly and a coarser mesh upstream of the injector to reduce the cell count. create intake port. And intake port bottom boundaries. Click on any surface triangle in the part of the intake port closer to the head and assign these surface triangles to the intake port bottom boundary. Assign the rest of the port triangles to the intake port boundary. Create a boundary named exhaust port. And assign the surface triangles from the other port to the exhaust port boundary. It is possible that some of the automatically created boundary fences cause some small strips of triangles to remain unselected while you are flagging the intake and exhaust port boundaries. Change the selection mode to box. Now, click and drag over the exhaust port near the unused boundary fences to select the surface triangles in that area. Assign these triangles to the exhaust port boundary. Repeat this process for the intake port and intake port bottom boundaries. In the next video, flagging boundaries for the SI8 engine geometry part 2, we will continue creating and flagging boundaries.